This episode is brought to you by Squarespace, the all-in-one platform to build a beautiful online presence.
I won't fight you.
You will learn respect, and suffering will be your teacher.
When we see life through a lens of pain, we see enemies everywhere.
You've always thrown everything you could at me. Well, I can take it, and now I can give it back!
Pride is a mask for self-loathing.
He wants to prove that he can do it. He wants to prove that he can channel the lightning. He wants to prove that he can be strong. He wants to prove that he can regain his honor.
And if he can't do it, then he deserves to be punished.
That's who you are, Zuko. Someone who keeps fighting even though it's hard.
The judgments and the rejections of the people who hold those prejudices,
I hate you.
They're not actual reflections on who you are or what you're worth.
It's time for you to look inward and begin asking yourself the big questions.
And who I am is already worthy.
Who are you? And what do you want?
That's rough, buddy.
Hello and welcome to Cinema Therapy. I'm Jonathan Decker, licensed therapist who loves movies.
I'm Alan Seawright, a professional filmmaker who needs therapy.
And today we're going to be talking about Zuko, a little bit of villain therapy. So we generally don't do TV shows. We especially don't do TV shows this long.
That are 60 episodes?
But it's Avatar.
It's Avatar The Last Airbender. This is literally, I went through, I pulled all the notes and the comments and the everything. This is our most requested episode of all time.
Watch it, damn it.
This is on you.
We're going to be looking at the effects of trauma, specifically in Zuko's case, abuse and rejection.
By his father and sister?
Yes, from his father and his sister. And recognizing that being traumatized doesn't make you a villain. Your choices make you a villain.
Yes.
And Zuko inherited his choice patterns from his culture and from his family. And the key thing is, in order for it to change, he couldn't wait for them to change it. He had to change it.
Well, and this should be like villain asterisk therapy,
yeah.
Right?
Because
it starts very much villain, but by the end, freaking, I love you, Zuko.
Please, Father, I only had the Fire Nation's best interest at heart. I'm sorry I spoke out of turn.
You will fight for your honor.
I meant you no disrespect. I am your loyal son.
Who fight me, the Fire Joker.
And fight, Prince Zuko.
Yeah, Mark Hamill.
Luke, the Fire Joker.
You will learn respect. And suffering.
Look at how he trembles.
Be your teacher. I looked away.
First time we see Azula in the entire show. He's right there.
Uncle Iroh telling the story.
I always thought that Prince Zuko was in a training accident.
It was no accident. After the duel, the Fire Lord said that by refusing to fight, Zuko had shown shameful weakness. As punishment, he was banished and sent to capture the Avatar. Only then could he return with his honor.
So that's why he's so obsessed. Capturing the Avatar is the only chance he has of things returning to normal.
Things will never return to normal. But the important thing is, the Avatar gives Zuko hope.
Something I love about this scene psychologically, the context is this is the crew of the ship.
Mm-hmm.
Zuko is a petulant teenage brat captain.
Yeah.
And none of them can stand him. They all respect Iroh. And Iroh's giving them a little context for why Zuko is the way he is. Key to therapy and key to healthy relationships is that everyone's behavior makes sense to them.
Mm-hmm.
And if you're going to reach somebody, you first have to understand them. When you judge them, they close up.
Right.
Right? And it's just ugly conflict, which is what was starting to happen between the crew and Zuko. Zuko is the way he is because as a 13-year-old boy, his father humiliated him and assaulted him in front of a crowd.
Yeah.
And physically and psychologically damaged him. I mean, and that's just the big thing.
Sure.
Much less all the what I call micro traumas. Right? And I call them micro traumas because the DSM-5 looks at trauma as assault, abuse, violence, near-death experience, something huge and horrific and terrifying. But I also think a lot of the things we endure every day pile up to become traumatic. Have you seen our cinema therapy website? We launched it earlier this year.
It was so easy to build and customize our site using Squarespace.
Squarespace has so many templates to choose from with a wide variety of styles and formats.
So once we found a template that worked really well as a starting point for us, we added our own colors, fonts, and personal touches to make it our own brand and style.
Like the very strong branding for the Four Nations. I mean, all that red, so Fire Nation.
So Fire Nation. Fluid Engine, the design system from Squarespace, not the waterbending system, makes it easy to customize all of their templates.
All of Squarespace's resources like pre-built layouts, transfer domains, customizable templates, and the Squarespace Help Center make it quick and simple to build a website.
So whether you need to build a website for your new tea shop,
or your vacation resort on Ember Island,
or your Revenge to Redemption coaching course,
Squarespace has a template that will work for you and you won't have to spend months building a website.
Or learning how to earthbend. They have built-in tools like video blocks and extensions for lots of platforms.
So our website can be a hub to link to all our other stuff.
YouTube, Patreon, upcoming events, our merch and popcorn stores, all the things.
You can also use their blogging or email campaign tools to engage your audience.
So check out squarespace.com for a free trial, and when you're ready to launch, go to squarespace.com/cinematherapy to save 10% off your first purchase of a
website or domain.
Domain.
You know what the worst part about being born over 100 years ago is? I miss all the friends I used to hang out with. Before the war started, I used to always visit my friend Kuzan. The two of us, we'd get in and out of so much trouble together. He was one of the best friends I ever had. And he was from the Fire Nation, just like you. If we knew each other back then, do you think we could have been friends too?
And that little eyebrow raise gives you the hint of there's a little bit more going on there than just...
Well, but here's Zuko. What has he not had? Actual friends.
True, yeah.
Right? In his own home, what he had was his mom, who's now gone.
Yes.
To save his life. And he's got a sister, awful.
Who tortured him.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think you called her a wiener.
Yes.
And then his father, who, despite being voiced by Mark Hamill, is a terrible person. When I started watching the show, I'm like, this Zuko kid's annoying. He's such a punk.
For most of the first season, it's like, boy, do we have another Zuko scene?
And then you get a little bit about why he is. And you feel kind of like the crew. Like, what's with this kid?
Yeah.
And you're like, oh, that's what's with this kid.
Yeah.
Yeah. And then you start to see someone who is hurting and lonely and isolated himself. And the craziest thing happens as you're watching this show produced for Nickelodeon.
Yeah.
Your heart aches for him.
Yep.
When I was growing up, Nickelodeon produced game shows where adults got slimed. How they've grown.
To be fair, it would have been fun to see Zuko get slimed.
But I can't get you home because of this blizzard. There's always something. Not that you would understand. You're like my sister. Everything always came easy to her. She's a firebending prodigy, and everyone adores her. My father says she was born lucky. He says I was lucky to be born.
Ouch.
I don't need luck, though. I don't want it. I've always had to struggle and fight, and that's made me strong. It's made me who I am.
He is fundamentally misreading Aang.
He has no idea what's going on with this kid. By the way, if you'd like to see an episode all about Aang, we have a Patreon exclusive episode, a full-length episode where we talk all about Aang and his journey from being a great kid to
world-saving prodigy.
The Avatar.
When we see life through a lens of pain, we see enemies everywhere.
Yeah.
And we see negative everywhere. And that's the thing, and that's why it's so easy to start to have compassion and cut him slack as the show progresses, is you're like, oh, he sees the world as broken because he's been broken. And I love his journey to being whole and healed.
Can I join you? I know what you've been through. We've all been through it.
That looks very Ghibli.
Yeah.
Fire Nation has hurt you. It's okay. They've hurt me too.
Yeah. Is this the first time he's ever considered the perspective of people outside the Fire Nation? Or is this the first time he's learning that, you know, maybe Fire Nation troops aren't all, you know, they're not all cuddly teddy bears and sometimes they light people on fire?
Well, he knows they're not cuddly teddy bears who light people on fire. What he didn't know is that their cause was unjust.
Yeah.
There's something called Cromwell's Rule, which says, I beseech you, consider that you might be mistaken. And people who never consider that stay locked in to harmful patterns.
Yeah.
And this, with the young woman on the farm, is the first time that he's actually considering, we might be the bad guys here.
Yeah.
Right?
Am I the villain? I don't think I'm the villain.
That's the biggest paradigm shift here, is actually encountering the people that you othered and seeing them as people.
Keep in mind, these are dual swords. Two halves of a single weapon. Don't think of them as separate, because they're not. They're just two different parts of the same whole.
Huh, Zuko, I wonder how that would apply to you.
I think you'd really like my brother, Sensu. He used to show me stuff like this all the time.
The show does snaggle-toothed kids better than any other show.
So great. There are so many moments of setting things up that are going to pay off later. Zuko talking about, you know, two halves of a whole, don't think of them as two separate things. That's his whole journey, is figuring out how to unite his two warring halves, right?
Yeah.
The Roku and the Sozin.
Yeah.
In order to become a better person.
His two grandparents.
Yep.
His two granddads, yeah.
And he takes a shot to the head and goes back.
His sister did it perfectly.
Failed. No, I loved watching you. That's who you are, Zuko. Someone who keeps fighting even though it's hard.
I'll be honest, the first time I watched this, I started crying uncontrollably, and I'm like, what is happening? I'm like, oh, this was my childhood experience, being bullied and being shown compassion by my mother.
Yeah.
He says, I failed. And why does he say that? Because that's exactly what his dad and his grandpa are saying about him.
Yeah.
You know, this is when we talk about in therapy, a reframe, right? The exact same circumstances, you tried firebending and it didn't go so hot.
Zing.
But instead of you're a failure, you're somebody who keeps fighting even when it's hard. Like, and that's an accurate statement. It's not just...
It's not changing the facts. It's
yeah,
not...
and it's not saying something sugary sweet that's not real to make him feel better. And that's what good therapy is. And I tell people, they say, well, you have to say that, you're my therapist. And I'm like, no, I don't. I'm saying something that is true, that you're not seeing.
Trying to learn how to...
Why can't I do it?
Do
instead
lightning.
Of lightning, it keeps exploding in my face, like everything always does.
Oh, man.
I was afraid this might happen. You will not be able to master lightning until you have dealt with a turmoil inside you.
What turmoil?
Zuko, you must let go of your feelings of shame if you want your anger to go away.
But I don't feel any shame at all. I'm as proud as ever.
Prince Zuko, pride is not the opposite of shame, but its source. True humility is the only antidote to shame.
Well, my life has been nothing but humbling lately.
He says, my life has been nothing but humbling lately. Yes, but that doesn't mean you're learning the lesson.
That you're not becoming humble. You're getting humiliated. That's different.
Yes. I think life has a way of repeating things until we learn the lesson.
Uh-huh.
And he's refusing to learn the lesson, and that's the pride. That's the stubbornness.
Yeah.
When you talk about pride being the source of shame, it comes down to ego. Because ego is the counterfeit of confidence, but it's not the same thing. If I have ego... And I feel like that ego's been damaged. I'm ashamed, and I must restore that. And usually I have to fight somebody verbally or physically to restore my dominance, right? Because my ego has to be restored. And that is pride. But when it comes to how to actually get rid of shame, it's looking at, okay, this was hurtful to me. If it was said, is it true? If it's true, can I learn and grow from it? That's humility.
Right.
And if it's not true, then it's a reflection of this person's prejudices or what they're projecting or what they're angry about. And I'm going to let that be their thing and I'm going to let go of it. Either way, it's humility and the shame is gone.
Should we do an episode about Iroh? Maybe Jono versus Iroh, see who can out-therapy the other one?
I'm going to get my ass kicked.
You are going to get your ass kicked. I'm so excited.
You're clearly outnumbered.
But you are clearly outmatched.
What's going to restore his honor is him becoming honorable in and of himself, which is humility.
Yeah.
You've always thrown everything you could at me. Well, I can take it! And now I can give it back!
Still pride.
Come on! Strike me! You've never held back before!
Why do you think he wants to be struck now?
He wants to prove that he can do it, right? He wants to prove that he can channel the lightning. He wants to prove that he can be strong. He wants to prove that he can regain his honor, do something that would impress Fire Lord Ozai. It's still not out of the right motivations.
And if he can't do it, then he deserves to be punished.
Right.
There is not a lot of self-love or self-compassion here. There is, at his core, there's self-loathing. Which is where the pride comes in, because pride is a mask for self-loathing. Mm-hmm. If you truly love yourself, love, self-love and humility go together.
Yeah.
Self-love says, like Ted Lasso, what do I got to learn here, right? Self-love says, I can handle whatever it is because I want to be better. Whereas self-loathing says, I either need to prove myself or I deserve to suffer.
Right.
First, I have to get it out of here.
And then what? You never think these things through. This is exactly what happened when you captured the Avatar at the North Pole. You had him, and then you had nowhere to go.
I would have figured something out.
No! If his friends hadn't found you, you would have frozen to death.
I know my own destiny, Uncle.
Is it your own destiny? Or is it a destiny someone else has tried to force on you?
Stop it, Uncle. I have to do this.
I'm begging you, Prince Zuko. It's time for you to look inward and begin asking yourself the big questions. Who are you? And what do you want?
Iroh is now saying forcefully what he's been saying softly for a long time.
Yes.
And if you consider the scene in isolation, it seems like the tone might be harsh. Like, the message is all awesome, but the tone feels like it could be harsh until you consider...
We've had 35 episodes leading up to this, basically. Yeah.
Of Iroh trying to get through to him, and now he's trying this, and it's all out of love.
Yeah.
And I love the idea of, I know my destiny. Do you? Or is it a destiny that someone else has placed on you?
Yeah.
When you come from a home of abuse or neglect or rejection, you're often taught conditional love. If you meet these standards, like Azula, then you'll be accepted and you'll be loved. And if not, then you're a disappointment. And we carry that within us and accept it as reality. And two things happen. Well, three things happen. One, we grow up and we don't question it.
Yeah.
Two, we grow up and we question it and we logically challenge it, but emotionally, we still believe in it. Or three, we do the really hard work of saying, no, that was wrong and messed up. And who I am is already worthy. And I need to let all of that go.
Yeah.
I used to think this scar marked me. The mark of the banished prince, cursed to chase the Avatar forever. But lately, I've realized I'm free to determine my own destiny. Even if I'll never be free of my mark.
Maybe you could be free of it.
What?
I have healing abilities.
It's a scar. It can't be healed.
Katara comes around real quick.
Mm-hmm.
This always about that hope.
From the spirit oasis at the North Pole. It has special properties, so I've been saving it for something important.
Sometimes that bites you.
Work, yeah.
Like it's going to bite her in a second. The sad thing about this is he's not deceiving her. Everything he's saying to her is real and true. And he's trying to change.
Yeah.
And then the moment he sees Aang, he's like, honor? Glory? Restoration?
This is what I love about Zuko and his journey is... He doesn't make a decision, and then now I'm good. I'm good now.
Yeah.
Just going to do good, good, good. Like, that's not how people is.
No. And when he starts to change and then he takes a major step backwards, it eats at him.
Yeah.
It's a metamorphosis, like Iroh said. Mm. He's transitioning into somebody who can stand on his own and not need his father's approval. And yet the exact moment that he has that opportunity, he seizes it.
Zuko, I am begging you, look into your heart and see what it is that you truly want.
You are free to choose.
The two sides of him.
Whoa!
Yeah.
And then a little dolly zoom action. Is he gonna choose? Not well.
I thought you had changed!
I have changed.
How? You almost did.
Kinda.
Well, and this is now the second time he could have been bros with Aang.
Yep.
And this is really hard. If you're a person like Zuko who you've kept hurting people, and then now you want to make it right, it's going to be really hard. They're not going to want to let you in. And sometimes they ultimately do, and sometimes they don't. And accepting that you burned that bridge and you're going to do better next time is part of your growth process. Yep. But you don't need to hold on to the guilt or the pain of it. Use guilt to change and then let it go.
Yeah.
You brought this on yourself, you know. We could have returned together. You could have been a hero. You have no right to judge me, Uncle. I did what I had to do in Ba Sing Se, and you're a fool for not joining me. You're not going to say anything? You're a crazy old man. You're crazy. And if you weren't in jail, you'd be sleeping in a gutter.
I just want to comment really fast. Zuko is lashing out.
Yeah.
Because he's looking for justification. He's looking for an argument with his uncle that he can win, that he can claim the higher ground.
I have the high ground.
You underestimate my power.
Iroh's not giving it to him because Iroh already knows. You didn't listen to me before.
Yeah.
You're not going to listen to me now. There's no sense in even engaging in this. And because Zuko can't claim any moral high ground, now he just starts resorting to insults.
Nothing proves you correct like smashing furniture, lighting it on fire, and then shouting you're crazy at someone who's sitting quietly.
We will dominate the Earth!
And this reminds me of one of the greatest, most insightful one-liners I've ever seen.
Reverting to name-calling suggests that you are defensive and therefore find my opinion valid.
Can't get enough Zuko? We've got a much longer ad-free director's cut version of this episode over on our Patreon. Check it out now.
Other stuff too, but mostly Zuko.
I like it when you express yourself.
Don't touch me! I'm still mad at you.
My life hasn't been that easy either, Mei.
Whatever. That doesn't excuse the way you've been acting.
Calm down, you guys. This much negative energy is bad for your skin. You'll totally break out.
Bad skin? Normal teenagers worry about bad skin. I don't have that luxury. My father decided to teach me a permanent lesson on my face.
Sorry, Zuko.
For so long, I thought that if my dad accepted me, I'd be happy. I'm back home now. My dad talks to me. He even thinks I'm a hero. Everything should be perfect, right? I should be happy now. But I'm not. I'm angrier than ever, and I don't know why.
There's a simple question you need to answer, then. Who are you angry at?
No one. I'm just angry.
Yeah. Who are you angry at, Zuko?
Everyone. I don't know.
Is it Dad?
No, no.
Your uncle?
Me?
No, 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 no.
Then who? Who are you angry at?
Answer the question, Zuko.
Talk to us.
Come on, answer the question.
Come on, answer it.
I'm angry at myself!
Why?
Because I'm confused. Because I'm not sure I know the difference between right and wrong anymore.
Little beach group therapy sesh. Pushy much? My goodness. Answer us! Answer the question!
Yeah.
I do love that he's home and his father talks to him and sees him as a hero. And I think part of what he's angry at is that's what he always wanted and it didn't fulfill him.
Yeah. Well, and that's where the I don't know what's right and wrong anymore comes in, mm-hmm. right? Because he did the right thing and he feels wrong about it.
Well, and as usual, Iroh is correct. Look inward and ask yourself what you believe and who you want to be. The issue with Zuko is that he's been letting other people tell him what to believe and tell him who to be, and they're not him.
Right.
And there's not fulfillment in that because he's trying to, he says, I was trying to get my dad's approval and he thought it would make him happy. And literally the only thing that will bring you happiness is being at peace with yourself. And that's what Iroh's discovered, which is why all he needs is some nice tea and a place to relax.
And a place to play Paisho.
Yeah.
That's it. That's all he needs.
You sent this, didn't you? I found the secret history, which by the way, should be renamed the history most people already know. The note said that I needed to know about my great-grandfather's death, but he was still alive in the end.
No, he wasn't.
What are you talking about?
You have more than one great-grandfather, Prince Zuko. Sozin was your father's grandfather. Your mother's grandfather was Avatar Roku.
Why are you telling me this?
Because understanding the struggle between your two great-grandfathers can help you better understand the battle within yourself. Evil and good are always at war inside you, Zuko. It is your nature, your legacy. But there is a bright side. What happened generations ago can be resolved now by you. Because of your legacy, you alone can cleanse the sins of our family and the Fire Nation. Born in you, along with all the strife, is the power to restore balance to the world.
An intergenerational trauma is exactly that.
Yes.
Right? What happens in one generation gets passed down, and the negative patterns and the abuse and the neglect and the rejection just goes down and down and down and down until one person has the insight of seeing what's going on and deliberately decides to change it and to break the chain.
Yep.
And this illustrates that so beautifully. It is, I can't think of anyone who does it better.
It's one of the best versions of this story or that story that I've ever seen put on screen. It's amazing.
So, how did it go?
When I got to the meeting, everyone welcomed me. My father had saved me a seat. He wanted me next to him. I was literally at his right hand.
Zuko, that's wonderful. You must be happy.
During the meeting, I was the perfect prince. The son my father wanted. But I wasn't me.
At the end of that scene is where he makes the choice.
Yeah.
That changes everything. That's the end of his decision-making journey. Right?
Yeah.
After that, it's just like, okay, how do I actually execute on being good?
Hello, Zuko here.
Yeah.
Which is hilarious and brilliant. Why am I so bad at being good? It's amazing.
But true to his mother, who saw him from the beginning, he's someone who keeps fighting even when it's hard, and that includes his own growth and his own change and his own progress.
Yep.
And that's the thing. He's like the Rocky Balboa of personal growth.
He totally is.
Because if you think of Rocky Balboa, he's not that good at boxing, but his thing is he just keeps getting up.
Yep.
Until he gets the job done. And that's what Zuko does. He's like, I will be a good person, damn it.
You can't stop me. It's going to happen.
And I love that about him, yeah. Right? Whoever you want to be, it's easy to get discouraged. It's easy to hang your head and say, I'm so bad at being good. The question to ask yourself is, one, are you bad at being good or are you bad at being somebody else's definition of good?
Right.
Because Zuko was both.
Yes. At different times, both things.
But the difference is when he was bad at actually being good according to his inner compass, he didn't hate himself for it.
No, because he was trying.
Yeah, he got frustrated and stuff, but he kept going because that was fulfilling. When he sucked at being good according to someone else's definition, he was pursuing something that he didn't really want anyways. He was convincing himself that he wanted it because what he really wanted was approval. Right. And I believe this to my very core. Being who you are and then finding your people is, that's it.
Yep.
And the Fire Nation wasn't Zuko's people. He's Team Avatar.
Yes.
It just took him a while to see it. So until next time, what inner turmoil? That's rough, buddy.
And watch TV
shows.
Yeah. Anime? Good anime night. From Burbank.
Okay, let's do that together. Watch anime
from Burbank. Hey, super thank you a whole bunch to our patrons. People like
Jody Galvano,
MJ Torn or Mitorn,
Stephanie E,
Holly Hammy,
and Lily E. They're sisters.
I hope so.
Why am I so bad at reading copy?